Hi there, this is Shubham Mittal. Today I am going to show you how to install Raspbian OS on a Raspberry Pi. So first of all, go to the Google and type in Raspberry Pi downloads. Click on Raspberry Pi downloads. This is the official page for download of Raspbian. Go to the Raspbian. And we will be downloading Raspbian Stretch Lite just for the case, because I use it frequently. You can also download Raspberry Pi Raspbian Stretch with desktop also. So it is a very small file, this is 351 MB, while the Raspbian Stretch with desktop can be 1.5 GB. So it will be downloaded in a moment. Okay, it has been downloaded now. So as we can see, it is an archive. We have to extract it. Okay, the archive is extracting now. Extraction is complete now. Now we have to write this image to the SD card. I am plugging in a 8GB SD card. So this is the 8GB SD card I have just plugged into my laptop. There is an utility known as Win32 Disk Imager. You can download it. It is free, open source. I have posted the link in the description below. So this will write the image to the SD card. It may take up to 20 minutes to write to the card. I have just skipped the progress of that writing. Now it is complete. Click OK. Now some pop-ups are there of the new disk created in this SD card. Now go to the boot partition. We have to go to the boot partition of the Raspberry Pi so that we can add the secure shell capability so that we can log in over the PuTTY. We are planning to log into the Pi using SSH. So we are making an empty file SSH without any type, it is SSH only. Now just eject the memory card by safely removing it. To plug this memory card into the Raspberry Pi and switch it on, we have to power on the Raspberry Pi along with the Ethernet connection to the router. Then open Advanced IP Scanner. The link of this app also I have posted in the description. Now we are going to scan the IP allotted by the router to the Raspberry Pi. It will take a moment. So as it is showing, Raspberry Pi has been allotted an IP that is 192.168.1.6. this is the Raspberry Pi's IP right now, so we can access our Raspberry Pi on this IP. Now just open PuTTY. This is also a lightweight installation, PuTTY. Type in the host name or IP address, that is the IP of Raspberry Pi, then click on SSH to enable X11 forwarding. Okay, just save this setting as a new setting, as maybe we can save it as Raspberry Pi 3 or Pi 3. Okay, we have saved this setting. Now we can load this setting. Click yes, login as Pi, and the default username is Raspberry. Okay, we have successfully logged in. Now we need to update the Raspberry Pi. Sudo raspi we need to type sudo apt-get update. It may take few minutes to update, depending upon what are the updates available in the apt repository. Now type in sudo apt-get upgrade. We need to upgrade the Raspberry Pi software. It will also take few minutes. Now we will expand the partition of Raspberry Pi using sudo raspi-config. That is, we are going to the configuration. Go to advanced settings, expand file system, select boot partition has been resized, then click on finish. Don't reboot now. We will update the firmware also using sudo rpi-update. It will take its time. Okay, once the firmware has been upgraded, we can reboot the system now using sudo reboot. And then enter. Then we need to connect again using PuTTY. Login as PI, username is Raspberry. Now okay, we are just testing it using Python. Print hello world, because Python comes pre-installed in it. Okay, it is showing hello world. The PI is working fine. Okay, you can use sudo halt. Okay, thanks for watching the video.